So it's almost the end of May, and we're going to be getting Summoner's War Update 727 soon, and that should include a balance patch, hopefully among some other things, but as we always do before balance patches, I like to go through and give my recommendations and my input on what I'm hoping we'll actually get in the balance patch, and then at the very end, we'll go through my predictions, which is going to be none of the things that I'm hoping actually get balanced. Well, a couple of them, but anyway, top 10 balance patch hopefuls. I did just 10 this time, so some of the units may not be in here because we left some out. So first off, I have to keep saying gargoyles because I really think that the gargoyles, it's so easy to just make them a very meta monster family, to just make them start as a statue. That's all they need. Can you guys even see that this says gargoyles? Should be better. I should have fixed that before the video, but I didn't realize it was going to be an issue. But yeah, gargoyles will be so easy if they just start as a statue. So many of them would actually be more useful because that's all they need. That such low base speed. I really feel like ComTwist knows this. I don't think that this is oblivious to them. I'm pretty sure they know, and they're going to eventually do it at some point. Who knows when, but this would be a great way to actually change. These are such cool looking monsters. I really wish that I could. I have all the transmogs. I really wish I could use these units, but I can't justify using them for really anything. So next one, Bayix. And I think that they actually will get touched in this balance patch. Who knows what they would actually do, but defense breaks, brands, strips, more debuffs. Most of them are single target. Yeah, I think all of them are single target units actually, but like the fire one, people are using more because of the defense break. I think it really doesn't take that much. Either put some strips on some of them. This guy, the dark one, strips after the stun, which is kind of odd. It's not something you would think of at first. You're like, oh, he strips and he stuns. It's like, no, he's that's the opposite way. So yeah, just strips, defense breaks, brands, other debuffs would make these units much more useful. It doesn't really take that much, I don't think, for those. This one, oh, we always talk about him. I kind of changed up the idea slightly for some of these that we usually talk about. I'm like, maybe we could talk about it a different way because we keep talking about it every couple months because the same units are very bad. In my opinion, worst LD4 in the game. If skill 3 triggered passively, it could be useful. Also, if he healed as a support unit, all he's doing is putting invincibility, and then it's like, and then what? Like, him versus the second awakened Light Fairy. She's just better. She's just a better unit than he is. There's no real reason to use this one. So yeah, that's Lewis in a nutshell. Here's the next one. Brian is the one that I feel needs it the most, but all the Death Knights. Win Death Knight as add a use for skill 3 even when allies aren't dead. But I feel the same way about Eladriel. I didn't include Eladriel this time, but we usually include Eladriel. It's just if he did something that was more proactive. Because the skill 3 only matters if things are dead. But yeah, I mean, you could say the same thing about a healer, but yeah. With these units, it's like if your team is already dead, you're most likely going to lose regardless. Unless it passively, like Vanessa passively does it and Nana passively does it. That's why these units are actually in the meta and actually good. Fire increased stats or skill 3 damage, because like even Tyrannus, there's resets, there's so many just revivers in general are not very useful aside from like Labyrinth and some other places, but or if you have a crazy revive comp like with the Dark Demon, but that's besides the point. So yeah, fire just increased stats or skill 3 damage amount could be actually much more usable. Some people still already use the fire Death Knight. Water I kind of like. I'm sure people have their opinions on the water one, but I kind of do like the water one. And also some people use them as a nemesis trap as well. Dark slightly increased in stats for damage mitigation. I thought this one might have been OP when it got changed like a year ago. I thought this one might be, and then the light one is actually, he's so close to being good. He's kind of like two different units. So his second skill is an AoE that does HP-based damage. He's an attack-type unit with a speed leader skill. His skill 3, like, he doesn't need to be an attack-type unit. Like, either make him an attack-type unit or make him a tank. Because skill 2 does damage based on HP. Skill 3 is a skill that, like, if you're in the match for a while and your team takes some damage, then you can use skill 3. It's kind of like Harmonia, but Yeah, it's he's kind of a tank, but he's kind of not a tank. If he's supposed to be a tank, make him a tank, make him tankier, give him an HP classification. Or if he's an attack type unit, because he's the only one, I believe, that's an attack type unit. So if he is an attack type unit, then make his skill 2 not scale based on HP, and make his skill 3 do something more proactive if you're going to use him for a turn 1 opener unit. So I think just going one way or the other. This guy, oh my god, the Poison Knights are cool looking units. Like, some of these units just like look very cool, and then you try to use them and you're like, I can't just, like, how am I gonna justify using this if I wanna see how cool the monster looks? Or see some of them have transmogs and stuff. Yeah, this one was never good. Not even for a minute. I tried using him so much. Tried using him in dragons. I'm like, nah, it only really works if you're already losing at dragons. So yeah. There's no real reason to use him in dragons. There's no one using Rika defenses. You could kind of use him against like Nora defenses, but that's the one niche. But then he would also, the problem with that, and I've tried this before as well, is that he gets CC'd, or he like doesn't get a chance to actually do what he theoretically does with skill 3. So it's just like, he does this one niche thing, but most of the time he doesn't even do it, even in that niche scenario. So yeah, he's such a bad unit. He's cool looking, and I want to give him credit for being cool looking, but and this is the same thing as the Dalsim as well. So this one, some people are going to disagree with me. I wanted to prove myself wrong, right? Because I saw some people think, oh, like, no, he's good. I'm like, just because a unit does big damage does not necessarily make them good. You need to be able to actually use them in things. So he does have elements working for him. He's got the skill too, which will put a revenge and also a threat state on one of his allies. So that's good. That gives him the start to do this. But almost always I see him either dying before he gets a chance to use that, because he's got to be kind of squishy, right? Or getting that skill off and then like not being fully charged, or it's just not doing enough damage. So either he needs some more tankiness to survive longer, or he needs something else with that skill 3 to actually get that kill. Because if you're gonna have the combo like that, may as well do a combo that, like, may as well use something else, which is a combo that's going to actually kill things, guaranteed, right? So, like, for example, in my opinion, Chloe and Katarina is a better combination, because then it's just going to ignore defense, and you don't have to worry about Katarina dying, because invincibility, right? So, that's just my... I've been using that team so much. But yeah, also, this could be nice with, that it either ignores effects that resist death or ignore damage mitigation. So those would be two nice things to put on that skill 3 that I think would make it better. I think he's close though. I think he does have his potential, but I just want him to be able to use it. That's what I'm saying. So we have Jara, which I always, she's so beautiful. That's a really nice, the art team does such a great job, but yeah, I just think Jara, if any of these phoenixes, if you give the phoenix a revive, all of a sudden they all become meta. In my opinion. I mean, that could be so far from the... They could be like, oh, hey, I'll have revives. I'm still not using Sigmaris. I think Sigmaris is a great unit. I think it's an underrated unit. So pure vanillas, I think they just need to go in the right direction. They know where they were going to go with the last ones. I think that was good. I think they just need to give them a little bit more. And they'll be solid. So just more in that direction that they've already decided that they were interested in going. Poopy tears. So the fire one, I think, needs a different debuff after this trip, or some attack gauge. If she has attack gauge reduction, she becomes too much like Triton. But kind of like that's what you need. You need something to follow it up with, more so than it already has. I know some people were using the fire one in siege defenses, but personally I think they could have just put other units in there and it would have been just as good, if not better. She does have the HP lead and she has an AoE strip, because people put in the Nora on there as well, but I just think that she needs some other debuff than that on skill 3. Because just all of those units that have that the debuff, the same debuff as the fire one, has the cleanse block debuff kind of thing. They just, none of them are, people are not happy with any of those. Wind, I think, just needs more. If with a strip, that would be, she would be a very, very strong unit. Strip to passive. So, because she will silence and she will decrease the attack age as a passive. But she just doesn't do, she doesn't do enough. And then the leader skill is garbage. So the wind one is just, yikes. Dark one should just be a cleanse regardless. I think that's at least the start for that one. I mean, maybe they could do more with that, but yeah, that needs to be at least, because she's outshined by Raccoonie, and I don't think that's very, I don't think that's quite fair. And then the two ways, I always complain about some of these two ways that just, even if they were only good for guild content, Comptuous at least cares about guild content. Some players care very much about guild content, like Siege and Labyrinth and inter-server guild wars. So if they just did, if they just made these units good for guild content and nothing else, I think that would still be, that would still be a win. Two ways don't need to be top tier RTA units. Just make them, make them more useful for some specific niche content. So these are my, these are my actual predictions now. So minor nerf, I've seen people's comments so much about, oh, Oliver still needs a nerf, Manon still needs a nerf. Personally, I do not think that they need nerfs. I think that they're both fine at this point because they were already nerfed. Were they both nerfed in the last balance? Manon was nerfed in the last balance patch. Molly was nerfed in the last balance. I can't even use Molly anymore, so I'm going to de-rune Molly. But that is, it is what it is. And then, yeah, Oliver was already nerfed multiple times. Manon was already nerfed. So if they nerf these units more, because people are like, oh, you just take off Oliver's speed lead. That just makes the unit not be used. He just wouldn't be used that, like, he would just sit in storage then. So you want him to be a storage unit, and then you're gonna complain, and then you're gonna, it's the people that pull him, that don't pull him, sorry. And then as soon as they pull him, they're like, this unit sucks! Like, that's what people were saying at the beginning, and they're like, do we want to nerf him back to sucking? And then you're gonna complain he needs a buff. Yeah. I'm afraid I don't think that they need them, but I'm afraid that they will get them. I know people are going to disagree with me because I've seen all the comments that want these units nerfed, but I don't think that they're people. You bring Manon in and people are just going to pick Ethna against you and not have an issue. So Ethna or other things that that strip. And then Oliver, there's they added the fire. The one we were just looking at, the fire pure vanilla, is a counter to Oliver. There's other counters to Oliver. There's like the Fire Robo is a counter to Oliver. Wind Monkey King is a counter to Oliver. The Dark Elven Ranger is a counter to Oliver. Antares is a counter to Oliver. There's a lot of things that are counters to Oliver. So, yeah. What else? Oh, yeah. So I think that these might actually get nerfs. I don't think they're going to nerf too much. There's not really that much that's like super broken. So, in my opinion. But everything seems like it's in a pretty decent spot in terms of not being crazy overpowered. Completely random buff to older Nat Fire family. I can see this like a skill 1 or skill 2 buff or something. I have a feeling that this is coming. I also think that they're going to buff Puppet Masters. I don't know how or how much. Minor Assassin's Creed units. Oh, they might also buff some of the... I forgot to put in here, but they might buff some of the Cookie Run Kingdoms more, the ones that I was just mentioning earlier, for example, these ones or the other ones. So minor Assassin's Creed unit buffs, which I think that they will buff some of the things that I think need to be buffed. However, who knows if that's going to be substantial, who knows if it's going to be an exciting balance patch. And then also random, there's always a random older Nat 4 family that was on nobody's radar, and then they're like, yeah, three of them get these good, like, really good buffs, and then two of them is like, they're already good, so we're just gonna give them like an extra dot, we'll give them like 5% more healing or something like that. And then also I'm secretly hoping that they forget to hate Celia owners and accidentally make her usable. She was better. But yeah, I was very excited about Celia when I first got her, and then they nerfed her. I don't think she's really even that OP, and there's still a lot of stuff that's good against her too. I'm gonna stop talking now. That's it for this one. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and we'll see if any of these are even close to being right when the balance patch actually comes. So anyway, see you as always in the next one.